Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be in Memory Pharm's Top 200 Drugs Made Easy coloring book, going over a much talked about class of anti-hyperglycemic drugs called SGLT-2 inhibitors. So if you're ready, then let's color and learn. Before we dive into SGLT2 inhibitors, let's take a minute and talk about what SGLT2 stands for, because it can be a little bit of a mouthful. SGLT2 is just an abbreviation for sodium glucose cotransporter 2, the protein that is inhibited in the kidneys. So as our kidneys filter our blood, they also reabsorb glucose through the help of this protein. SGLT2 inhibitor drugs block this process, leading to increased glucose excretion in the urine, similar to how diuretics lead to increased water excretion. These drugs are glucosuretic, so that increases glucose excretion in the urine. Voila! This leads us to our first memory tip. The drugs in this class all end in the suffix gliflozin, such as dapagliflozin, canagliflozin, empagliflozin, and ertugliflozin. Gliflozin sounds like glucose flowing. To help you remember the mechanism of action of increased urinary glucose excretion, leading to lower glucose levels in the blood, making this class of medications great anti-diabetic drugs. And as I stated, this class of drugs is indicated in patients with type 2 diabetes. It also has a unique indication in heart failure patients with type 2 diabetes and has shown to reduce the risk of hospitalizations. Some contraindications and precautions to keep in mind. It is contraindicated in severe renal impairment, so that's creatinine clearance less than 30, end-stage renal disease, or dialysis. This makes sense since you need a functioning kidney for these medications to work. There is also increased risk of ketoacidosis. Definitely know this, especially euglycemic ketoacidosis. In addition to that, there's also a risk for bladder cancer, fractures, urinary tract infections due to increased sugar in the urine, and lower limb amputations with these medications. You want to caution patients about the increased risk of dehydration leading to dizziness or lightheadedness, since SGLT2 inhibitors have a diuretic effect leading to decreased blood volume. Alright, moving on to the mechanism of action. As I stated before, SGLT2 inhibitors work by blocking the sodium glucose cotransporter 2 protein that is located in the proximal convoluted tubules of the kidneys, which are responsible for 90% of glucose reabsorption. This leads to the blockage of glucose reabsorption and increase in its excretion in the urine. That's right. Let's color in the schematic to reflect that, with the urine box in yellow and the blood box in light red. As you can see, blocking this SGLT2 protein blocks the reabsorption of sodium and glucose, leading to lower levels of it in the blood. For side effects, let's use the silly mnemonic to help us retain the information. SGLT2 inhibitors can lead to hokey side effects. H is for hypotension, since these drugs do what again? Yes, they have a diuretic effect leading to decreased blood volume. U is for urinary tract infections due to glucosuria or increased glucose in the urine, which can promote the growth of bacteria. L is for loss of weight. K is for ketoacidosis. Be especially careful of euglycemic diabetic ketoacidosis. And Y is for yeast infections, especially in the genitals. Some important counseling points to keep in mind. You want to take this medication in the morning before the first meal of the day. You want to educate your patients on the risk of hypoglycemia when used in combination with sulfonylureas and insulin, which can increase this risk. And last but not least, educate your patients on the risks and signs and symptoms of dehydration, including dizziness, lightheadedness, and thirst. That was a lot of information, guys, so let's take some time to review and see how much of it you can remember. What does SGLT2 stand for again? Yes, you got it. It stands for sodium glucose cotransporter 2. As you can see here, our visual anchor is two guys, sodium and a hokey looking glucose. You can tell by the name of the class, in which the S stands for sodium and the GL is for glucose. These drugs block the SGLT2 protein at the proximal tubule, leading to decreased glucose reabsorption and increased glucose excretion in the urine. This leads to a decrease in blood glucose and makes this medication effective in patients with type 2 diabetes, as well as risk reduction hospitalizations for heart failure. Moving on to side effects. Remember our hokey looking glucose? It reminds us that these drugs come with hokey side effects. H is for hypotension, as this drug also blocks sodium reabsorption, leading to a slight diuretic effect and lower blood pressure. U is for what again? Correct. U is for urinary tract infections, since increased glucose in the urine promotes bacterial growth. L is for loss of weight that is mild, and K is for ketoacidosis, especially euglycemic diabetic ketoacidosis. And Y is for what? Yep, that's right. Y is for increased genital yeast infections. Last but not least, let's review our key points. We want to educate our patients to take these medications in the morning before the first meal of the day to reduce postprandial plasma glucose elevation due to delayed intestinal glucose absorption. Also, you want to educate your patients to monitor their blood glucose closely and to watch for symptoms of dehydration such as dizziness, lightheadedness, and thirst. Alright guys, that's it for today. If you found this helpful, click that subscribe button for more. Let me know if you have questions in the comments. I'll be happy to answer them. If you're interested in getting more information about our Top 200 Drugs Made Easy coloring book, I'll leave a link to the product below in the description, and I'll see you in the next video.